Hello, welcome to part three. We're now going to connect everything up. I've got my kilowatt meter here yet. Just to recap again, this is for power shifting. Switch over to my battery here. I'm going to test my battery voltage. I should have charged this up, but it's daytime now, and I'm not using my daytime 27 cents a kilowatt hour just to charge up the battery that I'm going to be draining right now. So let's see what we got. Okay, this car battery is starting at 12.46 volts. A little hard to see there. And right now, I already have the inverter plugged in to my kilowatt meter and into the mains. It's got the screen extension cord going to my drop light, which goes to the ceiling, which goes over to my messy wall. Not the best setup, but I just needed a space where I could do my video. Oops. So, let's connect up. Okay, now they say you're supposed to, before connecting solar power, in this case we're using a battery, to the inverter, you have to disconnect it from the main, so I've just done that. Because a sudden rush of power or something from the going through the inverter, you gotta let it get up to sync. From exactly what the owner's manual had stated. No big deal. So, a little spark there. That's connected up. Let's see. The DC to DC converter is running. Now this DC-DC converter, I believe, said output can be up to 36 volts, and input, I think, was up to like 24 volts. Could have been like 24, 25. So ideally, if I'm going to use a battery bank, I'd have two batteries connected in a series to make 24 volts, as it'd be more efficient going into here. Less loss, the higher the voltage. Okay, so that's good. Okay, red light's on. That is the fault light. The reason that is on is because we are not connected to the grid at the moment. So, like I said, I disconnected it from the grid. Let's plug this sucker in. 18, 33 watts, 40. We're now pumping 67 watts, 73 watts, 81 watts back into the grid. I'm going to disconnect this. Now the DC to DC is heating up. I'll disconnect this real quick here. The indicator lights are showing that it is indeed outputting. Looks like we leveled off at 73 watts or 80 volt amperes. So yeah, there was a drop. I did notice with the inverter, the closer we get to that maximum output, the higher the efficiency has gone as well. Here. 71 watts, 80 volt amperes, 70, 71. Now, ideally, what I'd also do is I'd build some sort of tank or container and submerge this in a mineral oil. Even a motor oil would work just fine, since the oils are non-conducting. I wouldn't have to worry about it conducting electricity, and that would be a very good way to cool it. Air cooling does not work the best, as this thing is already getting pretty hot. So yeah, we leveled off at 70 watts, 80 volt amperes, it's 670 milliamps, Well, line voltage is at 120. I think it was about 119 when I started. I should have taken a note. Hertz, well, we're at 59.9 in Milwaukee. That is exactly what it always stays at. And we're at 86% efficiency. So that means 86% of the power going into the grid tie inverter is actually being used to feed back into the grid. I'd say it's not too shabby. It can be improved upon. I'd have to see what happens on a bigger converter. Let's see. I know there are heat loss. It's about, let's see if I, this has been sitting in here. It's about 52 degrees in my garage. Floor is 48. Garage door is 52. Ceiling is 70. Of course, I got my wall heater on, but the converter's already at, heat sink's at about 111. We go right in the middle, 124. Caps are at 160, depending on how I aim it here, 160 degrees, give or take just a little bit. Now, once again, this will become more efficient the higher the input voltage is. And I boosted the output voltage to about 24, as that is, the inverter takes 14 to 28 volt input. Of course, like I keep saying, the higher the input voltage is, it's going to be a little more efficient. Also, the more things heat up, it seems to be a little less efficient. But it looks like we're leveling off now. We're at 73 watts going into the grid. Our little test here is a success. Not too shabby, if you ask me. That's it for this little series. I'll probably be expanding on this more. Next step, now that I know it works, I will be getting a larger DC to DC converter, or depending on the pricing, I might be better off purchasing multiple of these and just putting them in parallel with each other to get me up to about 300 watts. What I've been reading up on is with this inverter, even though it's rated at 300 watts, and don't bother going to these websites, this company is no longer in business. It was just an importer kind of thing. I got this on eBay. Even though it's rated for 300 watts, what people have been posting online about is if you get to 300 watts, you make damn sure it's got a lot of cooling because it's very easy to blow, so on and so forth inside the inverter. So I'm probably going to run it at like 250 just to be on the safe side. This inverter was $99. I've seen them right around there yet. Bought it a number of years ago. And there we go. We're still pumping away. Oh, we're up to 76 volts now. Let's see what our efficiency is. We're at 88, 87 volt amperes. And watts are going up slowly. So, alright. See you on the next video.